Well, who here at the table was self-taught?
Well, I mean, I guess I was.
Makes an artist. In today's society, where resources extend beyond just academic school, people can learn from many different sources. So, self-taught versus traditional training, does it matter?
An artist is each a unique being. You know, you can go to school, you can not go to school.
I can't say it was really self-taught. In the beginning, I looked at it that way, and then I said, I can't say that, because my father was a professional, you know, and he taught me. He really broke down the science of photography to me. He instructed me to look at the entire Time Life book series so I could understand light, composition, themes, development process.
I can't speak on the advantages or disadvantages of being self-taught versus the other method, because I didn't do the other method. I just know the advantages for me of being self-taught, which is when you're self-taught and like being in New York and being hungry to understand what photography.
Literally hungry.
Deciding whether or not to eat dinner or to buy another roll of film. That. So you really want to figure out this craft that you've come to love so much. And I think that yields itself, I mean, for me, it yielded itself more to finding an aesthetic that was, I felt that was mine and that was pure.
To get the chance to bring in young, fresh, black and brown talent is so important, because sometimes these opportunities are few and far in between. So it's just important, because there is a story behind these photos.
I was fortunate enough to go to film school, but through the process, I felt like there was a lot of lack of resources and even just like concern about telling black stories and lighting black subjects specifically. And so I dropped out and I I was working a lot on set and learning from my peers and learning from like other black cinematographers that were putting in the work and have been putting in the work for years that I literally just did not know about, because we're not taught about them in film school.
You know, with black and white photography, it can become, you know, a lot of people definitely know with the sensors and digital, it can all look the same and seamless. So I had to find out how did I want my work to look. So I'm going to underexpose, I'm going to overexpose, but I'm learning when to do and when not to do it. You know, but it's interesting because I'm self-taught and you got these people that spend all that money to go there. But guess who's getting booked and paid to come talk to you?
Yeah.
A self-taught photographer. Yeah. I'm coming to your school and speaking that.
I'm gonna have to, I mean, I partially agree, but I have to disagree. When I was in high school, fell in love with photography. My uncle passed away and inherited his camera. I took the camera out of the closet and I started playing with it and accidentally took the lens apart, the zoom lens apart. My mom came home and she was pretty upset and she says, if you're gonna mess with these cameras and these lenses, you better learn how to do photography. My mom said, take a photography class so you learn how to fix the lens, which they don't teach you. I never got the camera lens back together, but I fell in love with the process of image making. I went to college for photography and advertising. And I think there's a lot of advantages going to school for photography, because you develop a community right away, you get a community of other people, and critique is essential, because if you're gonna survive this industry forever, you're gonna be criticized. Because you can pick a picture, and next thing you know, someone hates your picture. It helps you develop a strong sense of who you are, I think. I know everyone comes from a different area with that, but for me, it helped me do that. Also, just learning the history of photography, so we try to understand where things come from, because you can't reinvent a wheel, but you try to use certain parts of this experience and put it into your own work. Or you can also look at YouTube. Yeah.
Yeah. Which I went to YouTube University.
See, there you go.
I'm a blend of both. You know, absolutely. I'm, you know, as far as being a still photographer on set, I didn't even know the job existed. You know, when we shot School Days, I didn't know the equipment that you're supposed to be using. And when we shot School Days, the first week, I was trying to develop my own film in the bathroom in the hotel. I didn't know that there's a studio that you could send the film to that they would process. I thought I had to do everything myself. That's how green I was, you know? So self-taught is you know, you can waste time to try because you just don't know enough. You don't know what's happening.
While I do agree with what you're saying about the schooling for certain people, because I think certain people need to have that experience.
Yeah.
But I think in certain experiences that we have in how we grow up, depending on whether it was a family member or I went to a Catholic school where structure and having someone break you down and rule, I've had that already. I don't need the critique from.
Well, I think it's more than critique. I think what it gives you the history, the education, is understanding about photography. There's not just about, there's so much. There's fine art. There's so many different things in photography, and it exposes you to that so you can gravitate to where you want to go. And I think it's, for me, it wasn't about just photography. I was going to college. But you have to break that down and find yourself again.
Yes.
That's what it comes down to.
I went to school for photography and graphic design, so I had training as far as the study of photography. My academic learning wasn't any preparation at all, you know, for being a still photographer on set. You know, I really had very little work as a commercial photographer. Photography is just like one of those things where people will bring so much to the table of their own life, you know? And I was like, well, you know, I think I need to be in the real world.
To me, I don't see the value in it because, like you said, you control every aspect of it, and you don't have to rely on other people to make your work, like, actually good. Like, you just know. Or maybe you don't know, and you can explore that without the fear of somebody, like, tearing you down.
But I think it's important, just because of this, the community you get in college. It gives you the time to grow as an artist. And now, but it was a different time. We didn't have social media. Mm-hmm. You guys just take pictures, and you put it on Instagram. You could be booked the next day for a magazine cover. That didn't exist when I was coming up. It didn't exist.
But you can also get torn down by the world. in that one post, mm-hmm. And that's the thing. I think that's the other part of why it's difficult, because the level of critiquing is harsh.
I just remember sitting outside on the street one day around the way telling my friends, I think I want to be a photographer. And, like, everybody bust out laughing, you know, because we didn't know any artists or any photographers. They said, you got to go to art school or something for that. And I was like, well, if my homegirls can, you know, learn how to do makeup and lace front wigs from YouTube, I think I can learn photography.
My parents already, they like, she's gonna be a doctor. Right? Like, he's gonna be the person in the family, everything. Yeah. And at a point, I had to go like months without like even talking to my dad. So I remember reaching out to a mentor of blessed memory, and he literally put everything in perspective for me. And Kobe, he was like, when he was, like, he loved basketball as a kid, and teachers felt like he would never be a good basketball player. He's like, one thing has to come in one ear and come out the other. I love feedback. But there's also feedback that you should not listen to. Like, that can really bring you down. And one of the biggest fears that I have is sometimes just asking myself, am I, you know, you look in a room and you're just like, oh, am I worthy to be here? At the end of the day, are you authentic? Is there a genuineness in why you're doing what you're doing? And I think once I'm able to answer those questions, the fear kind of evens out and everything gets better again. But it's a cycle. And I think it's going to be a constant cycle as a creative.
Yeah,
I mean,
your rest of your life.
For the right.
They cut it.
Whether self-taught, a graduate, or a mix of both, we can all agree in one thing. There's no one way to have the eye. True visionaries come from all parts of the globe and walks of life, and all of our stories combine to form the fullness of who we are. The quest to always seek more knowledge is what turns the naturally gifted into icons.
I'm where I'm at now, not on my own, but because so many people have helped me.
My community of Black photographers made it a little bit easier.
You just can't do it alone.
Having Black women on my crew specifically has always helped me feel so supported.
My fear is letting down my community in some way. Yeah. Like, is my work Black enough? Is my work queer enough?
I have my days of imposter syndrome.
Came to a point where I asked myself, Juan, are you happy?
My career is not just my own. No, I have obligations to my community and my people.